Thank you. Across the night time, city wings a sleepless eye. Hear her voice shake my window. Sweet seducing sighs get me out into the night time. For walls won't hold me tonight. And if this town is just an apple, then let me take a bite. If they say why, tell them that it's human nature. Why does he do it that way? If they say why, tell them that it's human nature. Why does he do it that way? Reaching out to touch a stranger. Electric eyes are everywhere. See that girl, she knows I'm watching. She likes the way I stare. If they say why, tell them that it's human nature. Why does he do it that way? If they say why, tell them that it's human nature. Why does he do it that way? I like living this way. I like loving this way. Looking out across the morning, the city's heart begins to beat. Reaching out, I touch her shoulder. I'm dreaming of the street. If they say why, tell them that it's human nature. Why does he do that way? If they say why? Oh, why does he do me that way? If they say why? Tell them that it's human nature. Why does he do it that way? If they say why, tell them that it's human nature. Why does he do it that way? Thank you. She was more like a beauty queen from a movie scene. I said, don't mind, what do you mean? I am the one who will dance on the floor in the round. She said, I am the one who will dance on the floor in the round. She told me her name was Billie Jean, and she looked at me. Then every head turned with eyes that dream of being the one who will dance on the floor in the round. People always told me, be careful what you do. Don't go around breaking young girls' hearts. And mother always told me, be careful who you love. Careful what you do, 'cause the lie becomes the truth. Hey, Billie Jean is not my lover. She's just a girl who claimed that I am the one. But the kid is not my son. She said I am the one. But the kid is not my son. For 40 days and for 40 nights, love was on her side. But who can stand when she's in demand? Her schemes and plans. 'Cause we danced on the floor in the round. So take my strong advice. Just remember to always think twice. She told my baby we danced till three. Then she looked at me, then showed a photo. My baby cried, his eyes were like mine. 'Cause we danced on the floor in the round. Ooh. People always told me, be careful what you do. Don't go around breaking young girls' hearts. But she came and stood right by me with the smell of sweet perfume. It happened much too soon when she called me to her room. Oh, Billie Jean is not my lover. She's just a girl who claims that I am the one. The kid is not my son. She said I am the one. But the kid is not my son. No, no, no. Just a girl who claims that I am the one. But the kid is not my son. She said I am the one. But righteous mind. Love will come and take you home, yeah. Written in stone.
Do you believe, my friend, in what you claim? People of the world all doubt the same. Passing day, time will witness what the old folks say. Getting stronger every day, yeah.
Strength is written in stone.
Deep inside your heart, for you to keep, lies a spark of light that never sleeps. The greatest love you've ever.
Hi everyone, Richard here from Causey Light Big Band. Thanks for tuning in and hope you're enjoying the concert so far. Due to COVID restrictions and the absence of live music, we've brought the music to your living rooms at no additional cost. With this in mind, we would really appreciate it if you could visit our Ko-fi page where we are accepting donations. Everyone involved has worked so hard to put this together, and so if you enjoy live music, this is the perfect way to give back. We hope that you will feel able to give financial support to Cause You Like, as this will help fund this event as well as future projects. In this difficult time for the arts industry, your support is more needed than ever. Please find our Ko-fi link in the video description, where you can donate quickly, easily and safely. Thank you for listening, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the concert. Kozak Big Band is an 18-piece jazz ensemble made up of session musicians mostly from all around the UK. And recently we've been interpreting the music of a lot of acts, kind of like R&B, soul, pop, etc. But prior to that we've been doing a lot of original works as well. It kind of incorporates elements of improvisation and jazz orchestration. And kind of blending that with the genres of music that we've been working on, really. So the kind of colours you get from a big band orchestra kind of setup, and yeah, just trying to make it as accessible as possible, really, so that kind of it's not just limited to one audience. Came from actually when I was in Shanghai with the R&TM Big Band back in 2018, and we all sat around a table, students, and that we were just sort of agreeing that, you know, it'd be nice to play some big band music, and so I kind of, me and a few students at the time, kind of had the idea, and I kind of formed it, and then incorporated some other players that I'd met from other projects. We all met up in a studio at Leeds College of Music, it was at the time, and then just played a couple of original tunes. So yeah, it kind of stemmed from there, really. It never had any intention of going any further, it was just, yeah. My favourite thing about playing a big band, you know, is it's kind of like it's an ensemble that allows you to kind of let loose in a way. You can really play like you're in a large ensemble. It's also like, you know, chamber music at the same time, you know, section playing and things. Writing for big band is, you know, one of my favourite things to do as well, just because of the colours that you get from all the different parts of the band and stuff. Yeah. Well, I remember just before lockdown, actually, so like kind of like early March time, the R&TM did a performance with the R&TM Session Orchestra of Michael Jackson and Earth and Fire's music, and we had a special guest in Mo Pleasure, performed with both of those bands, and yeah, he was like the guest soloist on the night and played all this music with full orchestra and rhythm section and singers and so on. And that kind of inspired the idea. I'm a big fan of the music. I'm also a really big fan of the Jerry Hay horn section, which you know, recorded and toured with many of those kind of bands in the 70s and 80s and so on. So I kind of wanted to have a bit of a mixture of that style of playing, and then the kind of getting involved in string writing as well, which is something I've not done a lot of before. So yeah, it's been great to get involved in that. Uh, yeah, so I guess you could argue the first arrangement was done back in like May last year, something like that. I wrote one of the arrangements back then, just on Sibelius. Various different ideas came across. I thought I'd do another artist and things, but this particular concert idea probably came like, you know, September, October last year, where I was really starting to get recordings going. And we did release a track in The Way You Make Me Feel. We did that in like October. And we sort of just stemmed from there, really. But it's been a really, really hectic, you know, few months, really, just getting all together with the, you know, the writing process, the recording, then the mixing and mastering and so on, and people doing video editing and stuff. Yeah, it's been really fun, though. Pretty good. Sounds love to another man. It's too cold outside for angels to fly. Angels to fly. Rip gloves, raincoat, try to swim, stay afloat. Ah, dream collaboration. I'd have to say probably Elton John would be a big one. I'm a really big fan of Elton's music anyway, but also Paul Buttmeister, who arranged the strings and orchestrations for him. I just love the way, particularly on the album Madman Across the Water. That's one of my favourite albums that features like full orchestra. Another one probably Carole King, for similar reasons. Do Adele would be up there as well. I'm a big fan of that. So. Yeah. She don't wanna go outside tonight. And then the pipes flies to the motherland. Sells love to another man. Yeah, so at the minute, the plans, I mean, I'd absolutely love to start getting the project on the road, really, but I'd love to start approaching some venues. And now I feel like I've really found the type of sound and the style that we're going for. So yeah, I'd love to, like, you know, play at some kind of, you know, large scale venues that can accommodate this size of the band. Continue with this style of music. I'm really open to doing all sorts, like the R&B, soul, and just see where that takes us, really. But one of the main things I'd like to do is sort of collaborate with other artists as well. You know, put in sort of a unique take on somebody's music that kind of fits the bill, really, of you know, how we perform best. Daydream in this way since 18. And in the flight she flies to the motherland, herself left to another man. It's too cold.
Okay, here we go.
It's gotta be Man in the Mirror.
My favourite Michael Jackson song is probably The Girl Is Mine, recorded with Paul McCartney off the Thriller album.
Smooth Criminal.
Favourite Michael Jackson song has got to be Don't Stop Till You Get Enough, because it's got so many strings in it and I'm a violinist.
After the Love Has Gone.
My favourite Earth, Wind & Fire song is After the Love Has Gone.
It's got to be September. I just really like the chill vibe at the beginning, and then like the trumpets come in and it gets really exciting.
Probably In the Stone, which has worked out really well because we're playing that on this gig.
best musical experience? Ooh.
Has to be playing at the Royal Albert Hall with the Garrick Classical Project with DJ Spoonie and the Ignition Orchestra. A whole bunch of exciting guests, Craig David, Paloma Faith, etc. Really, yeah, an absolute musical highlight.
My best musical experience, I'd probably have to say, I've been really fortunate to play at places like the Royal Albert Hall, Isle of Wight Festival, share the stage with people like Lisa Stansfield, members of Joy Division, but I just have to give a big shout out to my granddad, who's mid-80s now, still playing the trumpet, and whenever I get the call to go over and play with him in Bradford, I must say that as silly as it sounds, that's my best musical experience.
The best musical experiences for me are when everyone in the room is super excited and is really feeling the vibe.
Best musical experience was when I watched PJ Morton play live in Manchester, which was amazing.
So one of those moments was when I played with Ignition Orchestra at their Garage Classical concert, and Craig David made a guest performance at the end, and none of the audience knew it was going to happen. And when he came out, it was just, everyone just went crazy and they just loved it.
My favourite country to tour, I think right now, I'd take anywhere.
Best country to tour has got to be like somewhere around Germany because the beer is so good.
I'd love to tour in Cuba because it's such a musically oriented country.
Let's just say anywhere in Europe so we can get out of England for a bit.
Of all the places I've been to play, my favourite has to be Dubai because I actually love hot weather and there's no shortage out there.
Any album by Hahn, any album by Tom Misch, and this is a bit of an old school one, but Amy Winehouse's Back to Black really gets me in a good mood.
Three albums that I'm currently listening to. First one is John Batiste's new album, We Are. Second one, Return of the Space Cowboy, Jamiroquai. And third one, I'm always listening to this, Born and Raised by John Mayer. I don't think I'll ever stop listening to that one.
So I've been listening to a lot to the new Dirty Loops album, Phoenix, which is just some of the tightest, fastest playing on every instrument involved that you could imagine. I've been listening to Scott Avenue by the Ye Yennings Quartet, a couple of guys from Snarky Puppy, just some really good quality bebop. And I've been listening to Circle of Chimes by the Norwegian saxophonist Marius Nesset. It's just some of the most ridiculously confusing but amazing jazz you'll ever hear.
Human by Dodie, Nightingales by China Moses, and Origin by Jordan Rakai.
It's the only right answer, it's Chinese.
Favourite takeaway is probably Chinese. Close one with Indian food though. Yeah, both pretty strong.
Definitely Indian.
You can't beat Chinese. But if you live in Manchester, you need to try out the Drop Bar in Chilton. It's Caribbean food and it will just blow your mind.
I like both beer and wine, but I don't know, I'd probably err on the side of beer, but it can't be brown. It has to be lager.
Can I pick both?
Oh, it's got to be beer. I do like a weird beer.
Wine all the way.
So I'm on my must be third rewatch now of Arrested Development. All the characters are completely horrible people, but I just find it so hilarious.
At the moment on Netflix, I'm watching Drive to Survive. I'm a big Formula One fan, and I'm looking forward to the next series of You. I really enjoyed the season with that.
Behind Her Eyes.
I have just finished watching Behind Her Eyes, which is a bit of a creepy program. It's one of those things where nothing happens until the final episode and then you find out everything and you're just like, oh my God.
was all we could do. We were young and we knew in our eyes we're alive. Deep inside I know my love is true. For a while we paid no mind to the past. We knew love would last every night. Something right would invite us to begin the dance. Something happened along the way. We used to be happy with sad. Something happened along the way, and yesterday was all we had. After the love's gone, how could you lead me on? Now let me stay.
What about sunrise? What about rain? What about all the things that you said we were to gain? What about killing fields? Is there a time? What about all the things that you said was yours and mine? Did you ever stop to notice all the blood we've shed before? Did you ever stop to notice stars, this crying of these weeping shores. You said were yours and mine. Did you ever stop to notice all the children dead for war? Did you ever stop to notice this crying earth, these weeping shores?
Yeah. show and how fucking strong is your fight. It doesn't matter who's wrong or right, just beat it, beat it.
Doesn't matter who's wrong or right, just feel it.